All right. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Depends on where you are connected. Yes, we are live. We are live. Happy new month to all of you. I'll go ahead and type in your name and your location. Where are you connected with us? Go ahead and type in your name, your location. Where are you connected? And let's give ourselves 2-3 minutes. Go ahead and type in your name, your location. Where are you connected with us? Happy new month to you. What a wonderful way to start your month. What a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful way to start your month. So go ahead and type in your name. Type in your name. And where you are connected, I know we have 1 minute, 1 minute to start. So go ahead and type in. Then do me a favor, like this video. Make sure you subscribe if you have not subscribed before. Subscribe to this channel. Yeah, Samo, Samuel Bishop, Levi from Abuja. Good to see you. Bishop from Abuja. Wow, it's like Abuja people, they want to dominate this trade this morning. ABJ, good to see you. Good to see you. Good to see you guys. Go ahead and type in your name where you are connected. I'm going to be giving you 2-3 minutes to do that. And of course, we are going to be getting started. So today we'll be looking into understanding market cycle. Understanding market cycle and discovering how to take unfair advantage of it. When you understand the market cycle, then you will know what to do at any point in time in your investing journey or trading journey. So this training is for you if you are a forex trader, you are a cryptos trader, you are a cryptos investor, or you are a stock trader, you are a stocks investor. This training is for you because every time when it comes to financial instruments, we deal with this cycle. We deal with this cycle up and down, up and down, up and down. But when you know the stage that we are in at any point in time, then you will know what to do. Babs, good to see you. Okwemi Lawa, good to see you. Yes, go ahead, type in your name, your location. I'm trying to wind, keep us busy before we dive in. And once we start, no going back. So make sure you type in then if you have not subscribed to this channel. Come on now, do me a favor, smash on that subscribe button. Make sure you subscribe and share this video with somebody. Or if you have to call your friend, text your friend that the training is starting. This is a free training. Okay, this is free training. The only thing you can do is to show up. However, happy new month to all of us. Happy new month to all of us. So once again, my name is Emmanuel Adegbola, aka the Forex Apostle. And I'm speaking to you from my home office right here in Dallas, Texas. They call me the Forex Apostle because I'm a minister of the gospel. I trade Forex market for a living. And of course, I disciple others to success and Forex. I love what I do. I enjoy what I do. I can do this from morning to night, impacting knowledge on people. So today we are going to be discussing the market cycle. What is market cycle? If you take a look, if you go to your, let's say we just go to any trade or any currency pair at all, you will see the cycle in place. Take a look. You will see up, down, up, down, up, down, up. You see, like this place now, you see market is ranging in this place. Market is ranging right there. And once it breaks out, you see it up there. And what happens next? That is down. So that is the same with every financial instrument, whether it's Bitcoin, whether it's a stock, whether it's it doesn't matter. It's when you have that initial stage, then you have the up and you will have the curve. Sometimes it will be like this. And sometimes it will be like this. This could be very flat Okay, then you start, then you go and you have something like this. So we always have this cough every area. I mean, you don't pray to have this kind of cough in your life, but trust me, one way or the other, we always experience it also, that you have a business and one way or the other, before you know it, it gets to the peak. And that is why even when you're in business, you should know the right time to exit a particular business. And that's why I love white people. They know exact time to sell off their business. They know the exact time to sell off their business. So that's what we are going to be discussing. I see Emmanuel Abbott there. I see Chizo, Babs. So now let's go ahead and I just want to be sure that I'm talking to the right audience. How many of you are investing into cryptos right now? You are investing into cryptos, or you have some cryptos, or you plan to invest into some cryptos. Type one, if you belong to that category, you have some cryptos, or you plan to have some cryptos. Go ahead and type one on that chat window. Let me see. You have some cryptos or you plan to have, because you need to understand what is happening. Right now, you see Bitcoin, you know, the way the price is fluctuating. And whatever happens to Bitcoin affects every other coin, talking about the altcoins. So if you understand what we want to discuss today, you will discover that you can apply this to cryptocurrency, you can apply this to Forex, and you can apply this to even stocks. So, and that is exactly what we are going to be discussing. Let me see. Okay, I see Levi, Okwemim, okay, Emmanuel, Babs, okay, and then again, good. Yes, right now, if you're on this presentation or this training, and you don't have cryptocurrency, then you need to see me for deliverance, because we'll be talking about this. Okay. The legend investor Warren Buffett says, you zig when others are zagging. Right now, you see many people, they are freaking out and they are selling their coins because they are not sure of what is happening. Okay? They are not sure of what is happening. But if you know what you are doing, if you know what you are doing and you understand this cycle, then you'll be able to take advantage of it. Let's take a look at the coin market cap. Right now, this is a cryptocurrency. We can see Bitcoin dominance is 42.1%. Ethereum is 18.7%. And as at this time of this training, Bitcoin is $36,000. Ethereum is 2006. But remember, this goes to over 60,000. And came back, okay, to this even less than 30,000. So if you click over here now, and you'll be looking at, okay, so what happens and then what is going to happen next? So that is exactly what we are looking into. Take a look at this right now. This is Bitcoin. If I go, let's go to, like, you see, like, you will not see the real curve, because Bitcoin is a new asset. You can see what we're talking about right here. You can see this place flat. This is very, very flat. This is where many people did not believe in it. And we call that a disbelief. And you can see, imagine if you have Bitcoin when it's picking up. Okay? Imagine if you have Bitcoin when it's picking up like that. So when you see people selling off their cryptos, they don't understand what you're about to learn today. And that is why we are learning this. So let me bring out this image, and that's what we'll be discussing. Can you guys see my screen very well? We call it the Wall Street cheat. Can you see my screen? If you can see my screen, type yes. If you can see my screen, type yes. You can see my screen, type yes. You can see my screen, type yes. I want to be sure that you guys are following me. You can see my screen. I know there is about five to 10 seconds lagging in my words, and before you get it. Okay, can you see my screen? If you can see my screen, type yes. Type yes. Okay, great. Okay, awesome. So the first stage in this cycle is what we call disbelief. Okay? It's what we call disbelief, and it starts like this. You can see right there. This rally will fail like the others. This is when many people don't believe in that asset. Many people don't believe in that financial instrument. And for instance, like Bitcoin. Okay? How many of you knew when Bitcoin was like a $350? Okay, $1,000, even $2,000. So that stage is what we call disbelief. Many people did not believe it. It happens in Forex, it happens in stocks, it happens in cryptocurrency. So that first stage is disbelief. And we're going to be going back up front so that you know how to be applying this to your trading, especially if you are a Forex trader. If you are a Forex trader, so let's see, come over here. Let's take a, we're just going to pick a pair randomly. Let's just pick a pair randomly. Take a look at this. Okay, this is GBP-JPY. This GBP-JPY. So you will take a look at this area right now and said, this is unbelief. Why many people don't believe? That is when we are down right here. Okay, that is the down right there. Then that is exactly the stage. So, and in this place, you will discover that many sellers are not selling. Buyers are holding their money. They want to see what is going to happen. And when they are looking, so if they want to see, okay, maybe other people will join, maybe other people will begin to buy this asset. And once they see that other people are buying the asset, then they themselves will now join. You see, right there, you can see, at this place, you call it a distribution. Oh, okay, yeah, the market is distributing or accumulating state. This is where people begin the smart one. For instance, like what we have right now on Bitcoin, this is a good time for you to start buying back, because you see right at this stage, look at this stage, right there, right here, you see, this is a disbelief stage. Many people don't believe, many people don't believe, many people don't believe. But if you are opportuned to have access to an instrument, an investment, where majority did not believe in it, it's always a boom. It's always a boom. Especially if you are investing to, let's say, stocks. And for instance, some stocks right now, they are like $5. They are like $10. Imagine if you have invested into, let's say, Facebook. Or imagine if you have invested into Amazon when Amazon was very, very, you know, cheap. When Amazon was very, very cheap. So that stage right there, many, many investors, they are scared, they are afraid of their investment, and then, of course, they don't want to put in their money into what they cannot guarantee. So that is the first stage right there. The second stage is when investors begin to build hope. And that is when we have a recovery is possible mode. Okay, what drives the market is people's emotion. What drives the market? If there's any news right now that, oh, Bitcoin is going to shoot to $1 million by tomorrow, you will see people will begin to buy. People will begin to buy. Now, if there's another tweet that, okay, yeah, tomorrow US government is going to stop American residents from using Bitcoin, what do you think will happen? People will begin to sell off their cryptocurrencies. So people's emotion is plays a major role when it comes to trading and investing. Emotion. In this place now, people begin to gather hope, and that's why you see them buying. You see them buying. At this place, you see them buying. Now, some people have now passed through, they've passed this level of disbelief. Now there is hope. Oh, Ethereum is going to get to 10,000. Ethereum is going to get to 20,000. So there is this hope that people will now begin to what? Apply, and they begin to buy that asset. Now, immediately after that stage, we go to what is called the optimism. Everybody make money when it comes to this optimism stage, because the market is bullish. The market is bullish. You put in small money, it turns big. And everybody is happy. Oh my God, I make money in cryptos. I do this. I make money with that stocks. Because everybody is optimistic at that time. This rally is real. Some people will begin to say, oh, no, it is not real. No, it is not this. No, it is not that. But when you look at it very well, at this stage, everybody is a winner. In fact, even if you don't know what you are doing, you still make money. You still make money. Then from there, it grows to this belief stage. Time to get fully invested. This is where you see people begin to borrow money and push into that asset. This way, you see people begin to sell even their goods, their assets, and divert. You see, one of the reasons why you see what is happening in the market is people start, withdrawing their money from the bank and push to cryptos. Then, when cryptos is crashing, what is happening again? People will pull out their money from cryptos and begin to send it back to their bank, or send it to another asset. So at this stage of belief, okay, this is where people begins to what? Everybody at this stage begins to make money. You put in $10, you can make $100. You put in $1,000, you can make $10,000. Everybody. Like here, you see, this is where people begin to use margin. I will buy more on margin, girl, I tell everybody to buy. This is where you see your mom, your dad, your friends, both the dog and the cat, everybody. We start investing. Everybody will start. And that was what happens to this. Is I'm going to be asking us, out of all of this stage, where do you think we are right now with our Bitcoin, especially? Because immediately after this parabolic move, this is where we get to this euphoria. Okay? This is where everybody feels that, oh, I'm a genius. We're all going to be rich. This is where you see few people. Like, for instance, now Dogecoin millionaire, we have three or four of them on YouTube. I believe there are some quiet ones that did not expose themselves. So this is where you see people, everybody is having that excitement that we're going to be rich. Now, when you see, according to what Warren Buffett says, when everybody is buying, that is when you as a person supposed to what? Hold your money, either you sell and start planning to get out of that market. Now, let's take a look at Forex chart again and see how this plays out. Let's come back here. You see, right here, I'm still going to come back over here. Now, we have this. If you guys can hear me, please make sure you type yes. I want to be sure that I'm not just talking to myself. Can you guys see my screen and you can hear my voice very clearly? Today's training is going to be very quick because we have you guys that are Forex trader, we have news to trade. So and we need to prepare. So today's training is supposed to take us like 30 minutes. Can you guys hear me very clearly? Okay, I see Okwebe Lawal, I see the Wu Okeo Chaizo. Okay, good. So take a look at this. When you understand that mentality, you see, like in this case now, let's say you are in this trade and everybody, when the market is going to the moon, I say, oh, it's trending up. If you understand what you are doing, that is the time to get out of that market. That is the time to get out of, because like the big guns, the big shot, the institution, they know how to set that bait for traders, especially the OTC, the over-the-counter traders, you and I. They know, for instance, the way the banks normally trade, the institutions, when market is going up like this, okay, you will see them holding position to even sell. You will see them holding position to sell. You see them holding position to sell. This is how the bank, okay, the institution, that is how they trade. Then what happens? You will see the OTC trader. This is where they will keep buying, buying, buying. Then it will now get to a point in this place. You say, then we have what is called FOMO. Who knows what that means? What is FOMO? What is FOMO? Fear of missing out. Fear of missing out. So everybody wants to be a part of that trade. And they begin to buy. But before you know it, the market starts coming down. the market start coming down. And you say, oh, no, I think it's going to come back. And before you know it, they lose money. So once you understand that stage, once you understand those stages in any currency pair, this is GBP JPY, we can use GBP AUD and the same thing, just zoom out and take a look at it. Okay, let's use claim chart. Let me just pick a claim chart. Okay, so something like this. Take a look at it. The same scenario, the same thing. It doesn't matter the pairs. Take a look at it like this. You see, right there. So when you are trading, you need to know which stage am I. For instance, now, based on what we have discussed, you can see this place that the market is ranging in that place. You don't do anything. You are waiting for breakout as a trader. If you are a Forex trader, you are waiting for breakout. You are waiting to see what the market is going to do. Is it going to go up or is it going to go down? You are not trying to sell. You are not trying to buy because the market has just passed through this stage. And of course, if you understand this, you will know that, okay, the stage we are going now is like this. We go up, we come down. Where are we going again? It's supposed to be up, then we come down. So if you understand that concept, you will know how to always, especially with the strategies and everything that we have looked into, you will know when to put your pending order trade. And you know, okay, this market is going to come back up. For instance, if you look at the USD card now, I'm going to go back to our analysis of the stages, but I'm just trying to draw your attention to what we are having. This is USD card. Take a look at USD card. Let me zoom out. Okay, see right here. Let me use a clean chart. See right there. Okay, so let me zoom out. See, where are we now? You see, this is where we are. So which stage will you say we have right now? Because like right now, you see this market is down. But I personally will not be selling because this market has oversold. Take a look at this. The market since February, it has not been to this point. If you use a tool like a stochastic now, you will see where we are. So you need to understand, okay, so which stage right now, will I say, okay, this particular currency pair is? Who can tell us which stage is it right now? Which stage, talking about USD card, which stage will you say it is? Let me zoom out so that you see very well. We have gone up. Which stage will you say, okay, we have? This is it. We have gone up. We come down. So you can see this is where we're supposed to go up, but the market keeps coming down right here. So it has what? Overstretched. Now, but when you now look at it, so which stage will you say, okay, we have? Market dot stress test is either is trending up, trending down, or is ranging. So like what I'm saying right now, I will say, okay, this is a down market. But then I will not be chasing the market to say, okay, I want to enter short position. Because with what I'm saying, once you put a sell position here, don't be surprised that is when the market will reverse against you. How many of you have experienced that? That when you say, oh, market is going down, I think I shouldn't miss out. Then you now place a trade. Immediately you place that trade, then it's like they are waiting for you to place the trade and the market just go against you. How many of us have experienced that before? How many of you have experienced that before? Let me see. How many of you, okay, chase over the accumulation stage? Okay. I see accumulation stage because you can see that on daily, you can see that the market is not really going anywhere. You can see it right there. You can see it right there. If you put in box, Let's see, shape, rectangle. If I put in this box right now, this is where we are. This is where we are. So for me to say, okay, now this market is going down, then it must break out from this range. It must break out from this range. So if we follow what we are studying, personally, I'm of opinion, 80% that we're going to go up than going down. Because and if you are looking as, okay, this is a channel, but it doesn't look so much like channel because right here, this doesn't really touch down. So if you look at it that way, I will not be holding a short position. Either you don't trade it at all, stay off it. But then if you are in a trade, like I have one of my students that is on this trade right now, USD card, I will be very conscious to be entering short position. Why? Because like what we have right now, the market in that place is actually on accumulating stage. Okay, let's go back. So Ethereum, immediately the market crashed. This is what happened in 2017 to Bitcoin. Okay, when it crashes, many people will say, no, we just need to cool off. Like what is happening right now? Now, let me ask you, for some of you, do you think the market, the crypto market right now, okay, looking at this Wall Street sheet, which stage will you say we are with cryptocurrency right now? Which stage, you get the question. Which stage will you say we are right now? Which stage? Take a look at these stages. Take a look at these stages. I believe we passed through the disbelief stage in Bitcoin. We passed through the hope. We passed through the optimism. Let me wait for your response first. So which stage will you say we are right now? Which stage will you say we are right now? Let me see. Come on, guys. I know there is like a 5 seconds to 10 seconds lagging before you hear my word. Okay. Which stage are we right now? Which stage are we right now? Because when you look at Bitcoin, the way it happened before, this is, let me look for Bitcoin. Which stage are we right now? Let me see. Come on, guys, I'm waiting. Which stage are we right now? Okay. Obis says anxiety and denial. Olusegun says depression and disbelief. Okay. Okay. This is Bitcoin right now. Okay. Chizoba says panic. Adenike says anxiety. Let me pull it up so that you guys will see it. Panic. All about this say panic. Panic is right here. Okay. Let's see. Anxiety. Anxiety is right here. Okay. Chizoba says panic. Okay. Global Tonkupa panic. Says panic or certainty. Or certainty. Well, we don't have that stage. But yes, you'll be looking into. Okay. Let's see. Emmanuel says depression. Depression. Depression, that's this stage right now. So are you guys saying that we have completed the bull market, the bull run? Is that what you are saying? You know, whenever we have a market, okay, and that is the essence of actually having this training today. That is why I decided I was going to have this training today. Whenever we have a market going up, okay, uptrend, we have higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low, higher high, higher low. This is where you will say, okay, we are in uptrend. Okay, that is where you will say, okay, a market is in the uptrend. So when you look at Bitcoin, let's go to the chart. This is Bitcoin right now. Let me go to weekly. This is where we broke. Let me turn this to. I like to do my analysis on the Tradermatic. So this is Bitcoin, and let's take a look at when we. Okay, So this is 2017. Yeah, this is 2017. So anytime you, I mean, for some of you that you're a forex trader, now you will know that whenever there's a breakout, normally there's supposed to be a retest, then continuation. Do you guys agree with that? Do you guys agree? So if we have this, there's supposed to be what? Breakout. Then we're supposed to actually retest this 20,000 zone. Okay, this 20,000 zone, we're supposed to retest it, then continue. And if you remember very well, this is what I have been saying. This is what I've been saying. This is what I've been saying, that okay, we broke. Personally, I don't have any Bitcoin that I keep as an asset. I trade with my cryptos, especially Bitcoin. But then we are having this training so that you will not freak out. I see anxiety, I see depression. I don't think we are in that. Seriously, I don't think we are in that stage because this is the last high that we have. So take a look at it like this, that we have like this, we have like this, we have like this, we have like this, and we have like this. So we broke out, we have not even retested. Okay, we have not even retested it. I mean, personally, I don't pray that Bitcoin will get to 20,000 ever again. But even if it does, we are still in up move, we're still in uptrend. You see, the way market moves, market does not move straight line and never retrace. When you have impulsive, there will be a corrective movement. You see, the way market moves is like this: up, down, up, down. By the time this pick up and take a look at even, I mean, I'm saying this now because some of you are a forex trader. This is a Fibo, and we are a weekly. This is Fibonacci extension. This is a 50%. Right now we're on 36,244. So if you have a market that is uptrend, this is our 50. Okay, now I hope I'm getting attention of you guys. This is our 50 EMA. This is our 50 EMA. This is our 50 EMA. This is where we have the price. So, are you saying that we are in downtrend? Yes or no? Are you saying we are in downtrend now? So, I mean, I'm talking about some of you that you have followed me, and of course, you know how we roll, especially with Tradermatic. Once we have this, once we have the price above 50 EMA, we believe that we are still in uptrend. So if the price falls below this 50 EMA, then I believe that we are now in downtrend. But for as long as this 50 EMA keeps holding it, as long as this 50 EMA keeps holding the market above, this is where we are right now. This is Fibonacci 50% extension. So as long as this market is above this 50 percent Fibonacci, and there is also above this 50 EMA, I'm telling you sincerely, we are still in the bull market. Is this making sense to us? Because I'm saying this so that you don't freak out. Take a look at Bitcoin on monthly time frame. Take a look at Bitcoin. This is it. You don't expect to have a market to keep going like this without retrace. So this is what we are having. You see, it goes up. For some of you that are trading pullback, you can see what we have. So this is a pullback. This is a pullback. Let me see what the manager says, sir. The buying and bullish momentum has dropped intensively from the MACD indicator. Yes, it has dropped because of people's emotion. But when you look under weekly, remember we are talking about long term. We're not talking about 4 hours. We're not talking about daily, even with Bitcoin. We're not talking about 4 hours. We're not talking about 30 minutes. We are looking to long term. If you are an investor, I will not chicken out to sell my cryptocurrency. I will not sell my cryptocurrency. In fact, if you have money, this is a buying back opportunity right now. This is a buying back opportunity because when you look at it, this is what we have. This is what we have right now. And this is our 50 EMA. Okay? This is our 50 EMA. Right there. This is our 50 EMA. And when you look at it, as long as this 50 EMA is still keeping the price above, I believe we are still in the bullish. I might be wrong. I don't know it all. But from what, because the reason why we are learning this, what I would be expecting now is this MACD Pro to come like this. And very soon, this is month of June, I'm expecting Grain, Instagram, this one here, I'm expecting it could still get down, but I'm expecting it to shoot up. Immediately, Bitcoin starts going back up, guys. Where we got to before we have this pullback, where we got to before we have this pullback is, how much was that? This was around 64,000. Around 64,000. Just like what we experienced. Just like what we experienced in this place. Take a look at here. Take a look at here. So, like, this is what we call the bearish market. The bearish market, because it goes below the 50, our 50 EMA. Take a look at that place right there. It goes below that. But for as long as two, we are still up, okay? I'm telling us this so that some of you, because I from what you just responded now, I see a lot of anxiety. I see a lot of panicking. I mean, my cryptocurrencies, my portfolio, fell from almost 120,000 from my Exodus to almost 50 something. I think as of today now it's a 60 something. Okay, but I will not chicken out to sell off any of my assets. I think the purpose of this training is for us to know that, guys, we are still in the bull market. If you look at take a look at any other asset. This is GBP JPY that we have been using. I will say this is a bearish market. So this is bearish market. The moment it goes below our 50 EMA, this is bullish. This is bearish. The moment it goes below. So right now, this is where we are. We are still above this on monthly. If it comes to weekly, so it will not always like, okay, everything we have to be bullish all the time. If it is bullish continuously, then that is not a market to trade. That is not a market to invest in. So the moment we still have our price above this 50 EMA, then we know that we are in uptrend. Is this making sense to us at all? You are free to disagree with my little analysis, but one thing I know is that once the market starts, like for instance here, it fell, then it come back. Look at this where we are. The moment the market shoots and break that region, you can see what happened. So if we do analysis and we say Bitcoin is going to get to 150 to 250. Some are even saying 500,000. Are you expecting that Bitcoin will just go from 19,000 and just go like that till we get to 250 without the retracement? Is that what you guys are saying? Because it doesn't happen anywhere like that. It doesn't happen like that. Success, just like what you see right behind me, is always like that. That is the curve. So there would be that pullback or retracement. It is either China does something, or US does something, or India does something. Something must happen. Something must happen that will make the market to retrace. Something must happen that will make the market to retrace. It cannot continue going up. The same way it cannot continue going down. It doesn't happen like that. If you look at NASDAQ, you look at S&P, so back to our studies. I don't think we are in this area right now. I still feel seriously, I might be wrong, guys. I don't know it all, okay? I don't know it all, but I believe seriously that we are still in this trail stage. I believe we are in still this trail stage. You see, market will not continue going straight line. Okay, market will not continue going straight line. Bitcoin has not gotten to euphoria stage. What we are experiencing right now, if you now understand what I'm saying, you will discover that right in this place, you can stay buy. Even though I will not put my money into Bitcoin because there are some other cryptocurrencies that could give you more returns than Bitcoin right now. But then, I don't think we are in this area. I don't think we are in this area. Feel free to debate me, feel free to argue it. And I know that time will tell us. This is June 1st. This is June 1st. We'll come back to revisit this particular training. And thank God it's online. So this is June. So let's see what's going to happen in July. Okay, like Ethereum 2.0 is coming July. A lot of things is happening to Cardano. A lot of things is happening to Polygon. A lot of things is happening behind the scene, even for Litecoin. So we are not in bearish market, guys, for now. We are not in the bearish market for now. We are in this trail stage. This is where, when you study what is happening now in cryptocurrency, you will see that old investors, they are the one buying from new investors. New investors don't know what is happening. They just saw the market is going down and they begin to chicken out and sell. But old investors, okay, they keep buying, they keep accumulating more. I will say what we are having right now is a buying opportunity. You know, it's just like when market is going up and you come back and you have the higher low, then it's about to resume the up phase. And now if you're a trader, you have opportunity to buy and your stop loss goes below. This is exactly what we are having. Just like when you look into this, let me, like right now, this is a GBP, JPY. Even though we say, okay, now we are up here. So the market goes up, it falls. Then what happened? It continues. Then we buy in this place. Then we put our stop loss and the market continue going up. So that is exactly. So you don't expect different thing to Bitcoin or Dogecoin. Okay, this is Dogecoin. We're going to be talking about how to trade. I hope you guys know that you cannot trade Dogecoin on MT4. You cannot trade Dogecoin now on MT4. Like many people are saying, okay, yeah, Dogecoin to the moon. But you don't expect Dogecoin to now move from, you don't expect Dogecoin to move from 20 cents and just go to $1, boom, like that. But then when you look at what Dogecoin is doing, you will discover that we have this, by the time it, so something will always happen going back. If you have any question, guys, make sure you type in your question. Emmanuel said, no, sir. What does that mean, Emmanuel? It will correct. Yeah, because there will always be a retracement. There will always be a retracement. Personally, when I look into cryptocurrency like a Dogecoin, I don't believe so much in it. But you will agree with me that what is driving the price of Dogecoin, especially, is the power of the community. Okay, it's just one tweet from another person, but it's totally different to a project like Ethereum. It's totally different to a project like Bitcoin, Litecoin, Polygon, and so on and so forth. So I want to believe so far that, okay, right now we are still in the uptrend. I might be wrong, but from what I could analyze, we are still very much, very much in the uptrend. We are not here yet. We are not here at all. And that is why you need to understand where we are. Just like when market is going up, it will be you will see impulsive, corrective, impulsive, corrective. So where we are is this place. So if I were you, if I have more money, remember, this is just a trading purpose. It's not any investment advice for anybody. I'm not an investment advisor. This is what I'm doing that is working for me. And I believe if you could copy what I'm doing, it will work for you. So this will be my advice, I mean, my suggestion, what I would do for me. Okay, you don't have to do, you do you and do me. But if I have $30,000 right now or $35,000, I could push it into Bitcoin. And I guarantee from what I can see that this $35,000 by December might be almost $100,000. We still have a long way to go in the uptrend. The market cycle is every 4 years. Out of these 4 years, we have 2 years for bull and we have 2 years for bears. And cryptocurrency, Bitcoin especially, just started going up, okay, beginning of this year again. It just started going. So it's not possible. I mean, nothing is impossible, but from analysis and from what we are studying, it's not possible in the month of June, 6 months. If history should repeat itself, I don't think we are in crypto winter yet. I don't think we are in crypto winter yet. I think we are still on this trail stage before we get to this euphoria. It's at this stage that I can begin to now what sell out my cryptocurrency. What I plan to do personally is that, okay, I would, by the time the market resume the bullish movement, I'm going to be transferring my crypto asset from my Exodus. I will transfer it back to Coinbase. So any slight signal like this, then I will sell, hold my cash. So by the time the market fall like this, then I will now, during this capitalization, it will now be an opportunity to buy back. Just like what happened when Elon Musk was to go on Saturday night show, what I did before that show was I sold off my Doge because I knew what was going to happen. People were expecting it was going to go to moon, but right then it crashed. Then I bought back. So exactly the same thing you do when it comes to market. So ladies and gentlemen, as I said, I might be wrong. But from what I can see right now, we have more Bitcoin wallet addresses. We have more Bitcoin wallet addresses, more. So why do you think it's more? Right now, we have more old investors buying Bitcoin. Right now, we have more institutions coming into Bitcoin. Right now, they are talking about ETF, okay, in Bitcoin and Ethereum, right? So when you look at it, you will discover that we are not here at all, okay? I believe seriously that we are still here, okay? And that's just my view, and that is what I would like to pass across to us today. So in case you have your cryptocurrency, don't freak out, don't sell them. I mean, don't say, Emmanuel told you not to do that, but that's what I will do. I will not sell off my cryptos, and I will just keep it because when the market resumes, thank God this video is online, and you will come back and we'll revisit it. Okay, I hope you guys got one or two things, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave your comment, feel free to debate me, feel free to post your comment. Chizoba said, don't forget to tell your disciples when you start selling. Of course, I'll wait. I will surely let you know when I'm selling my cryptos. But right now, I'm not selling any of my cryptos. I'm not selling any of my cryptos. Instead, if I have money, it is time to buy more. So tomorrow, we will continue with this training. But just in case you are watching this or you are connected with us, and you would like to be part of what we do, closed door, you want to join the Forex Apostle Mentoring Program, All you have to do is go to www.theforexapostlementoring.com, theforexapostlementoring.com, and we have three different types of subscription that you can do. You can do monthly, you can do lifetime, and you can do annual subscription. And if you have any question, feel free to get in touch with me. God bless you. I really, really appreciate you guys, and happy new month to all of you. I wish you wonderful, wonderful peeps harvesting month in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree over you that as you go through this month, the Lord will carry you on his wings in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not be stranded. God will send you help, help that you desire, help that your destiny has been waiting for in the mighty name of